I'm Bharathi Seshadri from Cisco Systems, and I'll be talking about estimating code coverage using CPU performance units, or PMU. This is a joint work with Ivan Bev and Stefan Pedit. So code coverage, the problem is actually addressing how much of code is actually executed during testing. And current approaches are based on instrumenting the sources, and this often incurs high overheads in code size, anywhere in the range of 10% to over 200%. And at Cisco, we have a lot of embedded applications that are very sensitive and intolerant to increase in code size of even 10%. So in this work, we investigate the idea of leveraging PMUs for computing code coverage. So PMUs are special hardware units that are supported by most of the modern process that helps in gather statistics about the program in execution. And there are two usage modes that are supported. One is counting and the other is sampling. So we focus on sampling. And the event that we are interested in sampling is the taken branches. And this is popularly called as the last branch record sampling. The collection of profiling data is dynamic, and it involves no changes to the binary or the sources, and it has less overheads as well. So this is our workflow. You build the binary as you would normally do with any additional support for sampling if required, and you run the tests on the generated binary. The samples are collected using perf, and they are processed using AutoFTO. So AutoFTO helps map the samples to the instructions in the control flow graph. And if an instruction has an associated sample that is considered to be covered, and all the instructions in the same basic block are also covered. So we have implemented this analysis in the sample profile pass, and we also implemented the dominator and post-dominator analysis to identify additional basic blocks over and above what has come from the samples. And the resulting data is used to compute the code coverage. So all our PMU coverage reports are based on, they are shown as a percentage of GCOF coverage and is line coverage that is being reported. So the graph on the left shows that the PMU coverage is actually dependent on the sampling intervals. You get different results for different sampling intervals. And the one on the right shows the result for a particular sampling interval of 20K clock cycles. You can see that dominator analysis has contributed to about 10 to 20% over and above what we get from AutoFTO and LBR. So we have coverage ranging from 35% to 85% on some of the spec benchmarks that we have experimented on. We also tried to improve coverage by aggregating the results of several sampling runs and also aggregating multiple runs for the same sampling interval. And that contributed to an increase of 5 to 10% of coverage. But when we tried to run the same benchmark on different inputs, that gave significant improvements. So for example, LibQuantum, one of our lowest performing benchmarks, just trying different inputs from 1 to 10, the coverage almost doubled. And even for the case of GCC, we have over 20% by just running it on different inputs. While the GCOF coverage does not vary much, the PMU coverage improves a lot. So in conclusion, we feel that this is a promising approach, a low overhead alternative for a source instead of source-based coverage. And the results really depend on the quality of samples we get. And for that, tuning is absolutely essential. And if there are functions or statements that are executed like once or very few number of times, it's unlikely that they may become a part of the samples and you will miss coverage for them. So in future, it'll be interesting to find ways to combine the PMU approach and the instrumentation-based approaches for further effectiveness, and also explore the possibility of test generation for improving the coverage. Thank you.